And the lack of knowledge of God brings lies. And y'all know that when you tell a lie, you got to find another lie to cover up the lie. And most of our little minds don't work that good. So we always get ourselves trapped in a lie. And then the consequences get worse because everybody didn't know you lied. And when they know you lied, this show is messed up. Well, let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you a little secret. You ain't lying to us,
or
to nobody. You lied to God. And God knows you don't have to trip up. He don't have to give you no test. He knows when you lie.
Amen.
He knows how well you know him. When you belong to him, everything that you have, everything that you are, belongs to him. And if we belong to him, we're here to help one another.
Amen.
God's going to take care of you.
Amen.
But he needs you to take care of somebody else.
Amen.
Somebody asked me, well, why did we send money to Haiti? They ain't got nothing to Haiti. They ain't got nothing over there. They don't make nothing. We just big brother. Part of our big brother is we keep them coming over here. Keep them fed over there. Maybe they won't come here. Amen. I don't know, but we're trying to help other folks.
Yes.
And you can think what you want about that. Amen. Amen. But we're supposed to be trying to help those less fortunate.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
And a lot of times we think we're the unfortunate ones, so we try to hoard for ourselves.
Amen.
Let me tell you, if you want to get out of where you are, give what you got to God.
Amen.
And put all your faith and trust in him. And he'll give you stuff. What does the Bible say, Brother Palmer? I'll open up the windows of heaven and pour out blessings that you won't have room enough to receive. If you're struggling, if you need some help, try God.
Amen.
Try God. But you got to try him earnestly.
Yes.
You got to try him in truth. Amen. That means you got to get rid of what you think is true and find out what is really true. And it's right here. It's right here. And it's in here. And it's in here. And when you know that, then you will listen to what God has to say.
Yes.
Truth and consequences. If you don't know it by now, I don't know how I can say it any other way. It has consequences on your life. It don't affect me. God's going to take care of me. You know that? He's going to take care of me in the way that he want to take care of me. But you missing out on your own blessing. Anybody here got any extra blessings they can throw my way? If you don't need them, tell God to send them to me. I'll take them all. Because, you know, I've been standing under the window. Every time he throws something down, I try to stash it someplace. But he said, well, if you don't use it, then you're going to lose it. Ain't that right?
That's right.
Huh? Amen. Amen. Now, you may not have no money. You may not even have no stuff. But you ought to have peace, joy, long-suffering. You ought to have the ability to forgive and be forgiven. You ought to have love in your heart. And if you got those things, then you're going to be looking out for those other things for other folks. And then God, let me tell you a little secret. Once you start doing that, God uses you as a conduit to pass along his blessings to other folks. Because even though you're going to do right by it,